Cinematographer Halyna Hutchins was remembered by fellow crew members and supporters on Saturday with a candlelight vigil in New Mexico, where Rust, the western she died making, was in production. On Friday, Chord Records released that an assistant director unwittingly handed Alec Baldwin a loaded weapon and told him it was safe to use in the moments before the actor fatally shot Hutchins on the Bonanza Creek Ranch set. No charges have been filed. Cold gun, the assistant director announced, according to a search warrant filed in the Santa Fe court and obtained by the Associated Press. Instead, the gun was loaded with live rounds, and when Baldwin pulled the trigger Thursday, he killed Hutchins. Director Joel Souza, who was standing behind her, was wounded, the record said. A drag racer in Texas lost control of his car and slammed into a crowd of spectators, killing two young boys and injuring eight people on Saturday, authorities said. A six-year-old died at the scene and an eight-year-old was rushed to a hospital, where he was pronounced dead a short time later, police in Kerrville said. Police said the investigation was active and ongoing. Eddie Rosario made history on Saturday and sent the Atlanta Braves to their first World Series since 1999. The Braves outfielder blasted a massive three-run home run that helped eliminate the Los Angeles Dodgers with a 4-2 victory in Game 6 of the National League Championship Series. Rosario, the fifth MLB player to have 14 hits in a single postseason series, was named NLCS MVP. Atlanta will face the Houston Astros in the World Series beginning Tuesday in Houston. The Astros beat the Boston Red Sox in the American League Championship Series Friday night to advance to their third World Series in five seasons. For the city of Atlanta, this is a measure of revenge after MLB moved the All-Star Game to Denver in protest of Georgia's voting laws. An alarming rise in cases of the Delta plus COVID-19 variant in the United Kingdom is unlikely to result in a ban on flights from Britain and Europe, CDC Director Dr. Rochelle Walensky said Sunday.